Every marketing team or marketing professional that I've worked with throughout my career as a web developer and as an owner of a web development shop has always needed a landing page in some way, shape, or form. So it could be a page for a campaign, or it could be a page for your website. Either way, you need a page, and that's why you're here. And I'm gonna show you how I use ChatGPT-4 to lay out page requirements based on the audience that we're talking to on the page, any requirements that come from legal or product or sales, and then build out a outline for the landing page with some placeholder content that our copywriters or whoever's partnered up with you can then take and write. And it makes it super easy. You can delegate this to your designers, to your copywriters, and then over to your developers with all the requirements and the content ready to go in a matter of minutes. So what used to be a daunting task for marketing directors and marketing leaders, putting together plans for this big landing page project that's gonna drive sales and growth to your company, now is a matter of 30 seconds or an afterthought. Even just giving the information to your assistant, having them generate all the plans and then delegate it out. So, wow, what a time saver AI has done. And let's get into it. I'm gonna show you exactly how we do it. All right, so heading over to our ChatGPT prompts for webpage content and layout that we have saved here, I'm going to just run through the motions. I mean, it's pretty straightforward. So I have one set up here that is for a client of ours that we were working on. For this, I'm gonna change it up a little bit. So as you can see here, we're working on a website for a client and we need some good starter copy written for the following pages. I'm only gonna do one page here. So I'm gonna update it to say for the following page. And then I'm gonna change this to, we're gonna call it book a sales call. And then you gotta give ChatGPT some background. So in this, we say you're a marketing guru who has tons of experience working in and around the, insert your industry, construction and building materials manufacturing industry. You are tasked with writing content for RubberLogic's website. So insert your brand. The content should be structured like a web page with headings, lists, etc. It should be about 1200 words. You should write in an assumptive manner about things. So this style one is very important. ChatGPT, as you may or may not know, it has certain mannerisms and certain things that it says. This statement right here will actually make it not sound like ChatGPT. So I'm not gonna read through the whole thing right now, but just know that this style is really important. This is something you can change. So third grade reading level makes it easy for users to read. If you're in a super technical industry, maybe increase it to fifth grade or maybe even seventh grade, but it's up to you on that. Tone, again, how you wanna speak to your audience. You can change all this stuff if you want, but this is how we want it for this. And then the final one, do you understand? Yes, that's important. So we're gonna copy this prompt here. Head over to ChatGPT-4, start a new chat, drop her in. And there we go. There's our first one. And then we're gonna work our way down to the next prompt. So in this prompt, we're gonna set up our target audience and objectives. So target audience, distributors who want to purchase RubberLogic's products for sale, contractors looking for information on how the products work. So this is, again, put in your target audience, put in who you're trying to target for this page. And then the objective, this page is meant to display the products we are offering in an easy to read grid. This is actually not what we want. So we're going to actually say this page is meant to lead our target, I'm gonna call it avatar, to book a sales call to learn more about our products, how we work with wholesale and distributors, and how we work with contractors. And then again, do not write. We have more requirements. So we're gonna drop this one in to ChatGPT, like so. Great. Then we're gonna head back over to the prompts again. This is where I sort of started to freestyle it a little bit. I will clean this up for when I share it with people. And if you're interested in this and you want this prompt doc, this is not available right now, but if you're interested, go ahead and comment below and I'll gladly send it over to you. So these are some of the top products right here. So we're gonna focus in on the Gym Logics line for this. So we're not gonna say, let's start with a product archive. We're gonna say, we will need the content structured with H1, H2s, H3s, etc. We will need written content and notes on how the layout should look. That's very important right there. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take the do not write, and we're not gonna throw all these other products in. That was for an archive that we were working on. So we're gonna just put that do not write again. We're gonna hop over and drop this one in. There we go. Looks like I don't have any more requirements here. One thing I like to do all the time is just interact with ChatGPT-4. So I'm gonna say, do you have any questions for me to better improve our conversions? ChatGPT is gonna spit it out. So what sets Rubber Logic apart? Do you have testimonials? So all this stuff, like you can work all of this in to your page layout that ChatGPT is gonna provide. Since this is just a demo purpose, I am going to just say, okay, I'm not gonna worry about this. Thanks, we will consider this in the future for enhancements, but I wanted to make sure that from a legal standpoint, we make no reference to anything that puts us at a liability. Just gonna add that. And then I'm gonna say all good here. Let's write. All right, book a sales call, Rubber Logics. Here it goes, that's the H1. And then H2, discover the Gym Logics line. H3, it's just dropping it down. And what's interesting is, I believe, so did I give it? Yeah, so I gave it colors and all that stuff, so it's breaking it all down for us. It's really just diving right in here. And it's breaking up these sections. Now, one thing to note with ChatGPT-4, and that's why this prompt isn't available yet for in our archive, is because, well, it's gonna give us notes on layout, but like it's not 100% perfect. So like, obviously, if I were to answer all these, I could get a way more detailed page. You know, notes on layout. The H1 should be prominently placed at the top. Introduce Gym Logics line right under the H1 for immediate product recognition. Each H3 under the Gym Logics line can be accompanied by a related image showcasing the product. The Why Book a Sales Call section can have icons or visuals next to each audience type. So when you look at this stuff, why book a sales call? Get answers straight. You know, it's not gonna be 100% perfect and ready to roll, but like you can hand this off. Like this right here is more than enough for a designer to take and build out an initial layout. If you answer the questions that it provides you, you're gonna get way more detailed. You're gonna get more content in here. So keep that in mind. Answer all the questions ChatGPT sends back when you do that when you ask it if there's any questions to improve. What I would do next is I would just take this, so copy it, and then just to show in this document, I would paste it. I have notes on how to fix this little formatting issue, but it's pretty straightforward. You just highlight the area, go to format, paragraph and styles, borders and shading, and I'm in Google Docs, by the way, if you don't know. Hit none. And then right here, we're gonna change that to, and then I change it to black, and then there you go. I mean, this right here is a Google Doc that's good enough for a designer to take, put it into Figma or XD or whatever software you're using. And then, yeah, I mean, you're good to roll there. So there you have it. That's how it's done. Right there, I have my initial requirements for the page. Could have made it a little more detailed if this was more of a real life example. You can also isolate certain areas of the page and tell it to emphasize or make a more intricate layout or provide more creative options. You can do all that stuff. I highly recommend interfacing with ChatGPT-4 when you're creating requirements and you're creating delegation documents to hand off to your team. Definitely interfacing with ChatGPT more frequently will get you a better output, but hopefully this gives you an overview and just like a high level idea on how you can integrate ChatGPT and ChatGPT-4 into your day-to-day marketing tasks. If you have any questions at all, you know, leave them in the comments. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And I release a video every week, so hit the notification bell, and I look forward to hearing from you in the comments. Have a great day.